After buying as many coffee makers as it would take to get my partner to leave me minus one, I found that the cheapest machines can brew coffee just as well as the more expensive ones, provided you put in a little extra effort. Here are my main tips first, so you can get started brewing better coffee with the machine you already have. Clean it to the point that its surfaces don't change the flavor of your water. Recirculate water in your machine to help get hotter, and stir your grounds once or twice at the beginning to make sure it's brewing evenly. First and foremost, your coffee maker needs a real cleaning. Clean the whole thing now, and keep clean any surfaces so that the water that circulates through it doesn't pick up any flavors. A dirty machine cannot make a clean cup of coffee. Another thing to consider is scale, which is a problem if you have hard water. Basically, you need to descale if your machine builds up a residue as you use it. Run a mixture of vinegar and water through the machine, and then run another round of water to rinse all the vinegar flavor out. The main design flaw, from a flavor standpoint, in conventional coffee makers is that they circulate water in less time than it takes to heat it to the proper temperature. Most generic machines only heat water up to 175 degrees Fahrenheit or so, and you really need it closer to 200 degrees. The easiest way I've found of getting hotter water is to recirculate it, which can be achieved by swinging the shower head back into the tank. Or by brewing a blind batch and pouring it back before brewing. Another flaw in conventional coffee makers is that they get your coffee to serving temperature after it's brewed by using a heat plate. This burns coffee, makes it taste worse, and contributes to the fundamental problem I've just mentioned of how the machine isn't able to heat water hot enough by design. A couple pieces of metal worked for me. The most expensive machines on the market use special shower heads to distribute water evenly, while cheap machines push pathetic little squirts of water out into the basket. In cheaper machines, I've found little spots of dry coffee left over, which causes waste and inconsistent flavors. My simple solution? Stir your coffee at the beginning. You'll get stronger coffee because all the grounds have had a chance to contribute to flavor, and no coffee grounds have been extracted too far. Good coffee tastes good. And good coffee has been roasted recently. It has been roasted with a little care and attention, and it has even more recently been ground from whole bean to evenly sized smaller bits with a decent grinder. Blade grinders don't do this as well as burr grinders. They tend to make a part powdery, part chunky mixture, which clogs filters and leaves much of the bean unground and undissolved. Once you've effectively dealt with the more mechanical problems of brewing coffee, the main remaining source of improvement is the freshness of your beans. Coffee doesn't need to be expensive to taste good, and it doesn't need to come from a particular company or a particular place. It is best if coffee is fresher than 2 or 3 weeks old, it hasn't been roasted to the point where it resembles charcoal more than an agricultural product, and has been ground very recently. Coffee should smell mild and pleasant when in whole bean form, but it should have a strong, intoxicatingly good smell when ground. Old, burnt, stale coffee won't smell as good. When the technology is working properly, but your coffee still doesn't taste good, the blame may rest in the hands of the 200-pound gorilla. By this, I mean, you can probably change your behavior to make your coffee taste better. Don't sample batches early because the liquid that leaves it first isn't the same as that which leaves it last. People who sample early steal a subset of the flavor compounds, and most of the caffeine, from the remainder of the people drinking the rest of it. Time matters. Don't brew more coffee than your machine can brew in around 4 to 7 minutes. This often means your machine is lying to you in its cup rating and can only brew a portion of its maximum capacity well. Long brew times can over-extract compounds from the coffee, and this can have a negative effect when the coffee is left brewing too long. Luckily, recirculating your water, of which I've already described two benefits, can have a third benefit of more quickly brewing coffee or brewing more coffee in the same optimal time frame. After you've started each of these tips, you may find your coffee tastes too strong. If so, I expect that's because you're used to a lower strength, because much of the same mass of beans used before when done used. It's possible you could use more water in your machine or less grounds to achieve the same strength. If you need a new recipe, start with a ratio of 16:1 water to coffee by weight. I hope I haven't described so many things that it seems like it will take an hour to brew coffee in the morning, because once you've acquired the habit of keeping your machine clean, it only has to take a few minutes. Just turn on your machine, recirculate water under your chosen method, and brew as you normally would, stirring the grounds after the first few seconds. With hotter water, a clean machine, a good extraction, and fresh beans, your coffee should taste like an astoundingly large amount better. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see the next video, but I have no idea what it'll be about. Until next time.